Hey, bad buddies, Paul Roberts, Artsee1 here. I just put this together and I thought I'd make a video of it. First off, I'd like to say this is the 89 Returns cape made from a stunt cape. Now, what that really means is that instead of going all the way around to the front, it's a little more wide so you can do more kicking and punching. So you have a little bit more movement. Now, some people like this, some people don't, but the one good thing about it is it's got the spines, which pretty much line up with the scallops, or you can try to make them line up with the scallops. Where they come out of there, and they come out of there, they pretty much line up. But it depends on what cowl you have. I did this cowl, this is my own cowl that I did about almost 30 years ago. I don't know how the other ones will line up, but the cymbal placement is a little low. Now, depending on how broad your shoulders are, that's gonna affect how high or how low you wanna hang the cape and the armor. This cape is made for 5'10 people, Keaton height. So why do I have it up so high? Well, I just need to adjust the stand. This would be down, and the goal is to get this so that it comes right about there, and that it hangs nice and flush. Sometimes what you have to do is cinch it together a little bit, depending on your build, to make that happen. So I'm gonna turn around and show you what we have here. If you line this up like this, this one comes pretty close to lining up, but they're pretty close, and that one's pretty close. Depending on how low or how high you wear your cape and your build, you can adjust those seam lines and where they fall a little bit on whatever cowl you have. But a lot of people don't care about that. A lot of people just say, hey, it's got the texture, I'm fine. It's the best I can do. And it really is, as far as I know. This is just lightly armor-alled. If you want to, you would need to armor-all it heavier or ask for it not armor-alled, plasti-dip the whole thing, and then armor-all it for the deepest dark. But if you take and armor-all this, it'll soak into it. It'll give it a really nice shiny dark finish, and it'll accentuate the texture. This one is the one that really doesn't line up too well with the spine. And then you're back to lining up pretty well. And of course, that's just for me and my cowl. Every cowl is gonna be different. Every person's gonna be different. My cowl has a lower cymbal placement because I'm 6'3". And so you're gonna wear it a little lower. My cowl is really made for a taller person, but latex does shrink a little bit. So it's gonna go up just a little bit, and somewhere within the range of 6'3" to 5'10" could still use this cowl, depending on how you place the armor. The one thing you don't want to do is place the armor too low so it looks like it's sagging. What I would do instead is just raise it up a little bit if you're shorter and bypass the cymbal holder. Bypass this, have it go underneath like this. It'll be a little closer right here, but it'll be better to be a little closer there and have it not look like it's sagging on you. So as you see, it has the raised seam lines. It has the texture, and it has the cut and shape and size and length for a Keaton stunt cape. This is my 25th anniversary cowl. So if you have one of the originals, you have something very special. I've still got one, and they hold up over 25 years. If you keep them out of the sun, almost 30 years, they hold up. I've got one right here, I'll show it to you. It's really dusty, but this is an original. So they last a good long time. Look, I even got some spider webs on this. You're ready for your annual bath. But the latex will last a long time if you use high quality latex. I use high quality medical grade latex, even beyond some of the latex that's used for some of the effect shops. And there's some good things about latex, and there's some negatives. It takes a little more time to work with it. You have to treat each one, but it'll hold up the distance and it'll stretch. I have another video talking about this cowl that you can look at if you want in more detail. But this was just kind of to give you an idea of what this is. Of course, you could put this over, but the inside doesn't have the same texture. That probably doesn't bother many people. It's pretty close. It's got a texture. What I like to do is attach this to a metal plate and go through this and attach it on the other side with bolts. That's the best way to do it, and you're never gonna come unglued when you're out there at a convention or something like that. It's a little more trouble to get on, but that's what I recommend if you wanna wear your cape like this. This piece is not treated with plasti-dip yet. You see a few water spots on it. I haven't thoroughly cleaned it. It's ready to go out. And the bad buddy that has it and works with it will plasti-dip it himself and treat it the way he wants to have it treated to apply it to his suit with either straps or glue. And that's about all I have to show you for today on this. Just want to make this a quick video just to kind of show you what we're talking about when we put these pieces together.